Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So you are teaching with me what components of food. Okay, in that already we have discussed about some nutrients that are carbohydrates and proteins. So today we'll try one test. So today we will take one test. With the help of that test we'll come to know that given food material containing protein or no, or if there is a presence of protein in that given food sample. Okay, so with the help of the some chemicals we can take some test. Okay, to test presence of proteins in a given food. So to do that certain activity we require the certain types of the chemicals. Okay, so what we need for that, we require a, instead of the boiled egg, in the textbook it is given the boiled egg, but instead of the boiled egg here I have taken the meal. Okay, here I have taken the meal, also here I have taken the copper sulfate solution. Okay, it is called as what? Copper sulfate solution. And here I have taken the caustic soda. Now caustic soda means what? Sodium hydroxide. Okay, here I have taken the caustic soda that already I have prepared the solution. So this is the solution of caustic soda and this is the solution of copper sulfate. We require some droppers and we require the test tube. Okay, so let's do the activity. And what is the aim of our activity? What? To test presence of protein in a given food. Okay, this is what we are doing. We are trying to find out whether the given food material containing protein or no. Okay, so let's start with the activity. Here I will take one test tube. In this test tube I will add some drop of milk. Okay, so see here I will add some drops of milk in this. Okay, so here I have taken the some amount of the milk in it. Now I will add the 2 to 3 drops of copper sulfate solution. Okay, then I will mix it properly. I will shake the test tube. And now I will add the 9 to 10 drops of caustic soda, that is what? Sodium hydroxide. Okay, so dear students, can you see the change in the color? Yes, what is the color of the milk? That is white. But when we add these different chemicals, which chemicals we have added in that? We have added copper sulfate solution and we have added the sodium chloride hydroxide also. Okay, we have added the sodium hydroxide also. By adding all these, what we can say that, see, you can see the change in the color. We get the violet color. So this violet color in conclusion is what, or what it indicates? That the given milk or the given food sample, that which food sample we have taken? Milk. So the milk contains the protein in it. Why we can say that milk contains the protein in it? Because by adding the chemicals it provides the violet color, and this violet color it says that milk contains the protein. So with the help of the different food stuff we can do this activity. That we can use the crushed pulses, you can eat the some portion of the white portion of the egg. Okay, so in this way with the help of the different food material we can do this activity to find out whether the food material containing protein in it. Okay, so this is about the protein test. So my dear students, so if you have observed your hair, your nail, okay, then your muscles and silk clothes that we are using. So all these the different things, your hair, your nails, your muscles, all these are made up of what? Proteins. Okay, and even the silk which we are using, the silk clothes we are using, that are made up of protein. So these hair, nails, muscles are made up of protein. The silk is also made up of protein. Okay, so up till now we have discussed about the two nutrients, that are carbohydrates and proteins. Okay, so in the beginning only we have said that the different food material contained different types of the nutrients. Okay, so the some food material contain more than one nutrient in it, but among all it were some type of the nutrients are more in amount. For example, we can say that rice is there. Okay, so rice contains the carbohydrate, and with the help of the carbohydrate it contains some other nutrients too. It contains the some amount of protein also, but it contains the more amount of carbohydrate. a different amount of nutrient, but among that nutrient, some amount of the nutrients it contains in a more amount. That's why they are called as what? That. So here we have taken the example for the rice. So rice is rich in the carbohydrates. It is called as carbohydrate rich food. Okay. So today we'll move for the next point, and today we'll start our next nutrient, that is nothing but what? Fats. Okay. So the fats also provide us energy. Okay. And which food or nutrient also provide us energy? Yes, you are correct. Carbohydrate also provides the energy. Okay. So the carbohydrate also provides the energy, and the fats also provides the energy. Okay. But the amount of the energy is given by the fat is what? More. If we do the comparison between the carbohydrate and the fats, then the energy we are getting from the fats is more as compared to the carbohydrate. Okay. So since the fats are giving us energy, that's why the fat is also called as what? Energy giving food. Okay. The fat is also called as energy giving food materials. Okay. So these fats are also obtained from the plants and animal sources. So let's see the, which are the sources of fats. The sources of fats are ghee, oil, butter, milk, meat, and etc. Because there are so many which contains the fats. So in this way, the fats gives us energy. Next one. So here we have said that the fats gives us energy more than the carbohydrates. So it means we have to take the more amount of the fats to get the energy. No, the answer is what? No, we cannot take the fats in an excessive amount. Why? Because the excessive amount of the fat is get stored in our body, and that stored fat causes the obesity. Okay. So the what? The fat stored in the body causes obesity. Obesity means what? The person gets fatty so much. Okay. So in this way, the person is getting increase in a weight and it gets fat, and it is called as what? Obesity. So still the fat is giving us more energy. Cannot take the fat in a more amount, in an excessive amount, because the excessive amount of the fat gets stored in our body and it causes the disease, and the name of the disease is what? Obesity. Okay. So this is about the fats. Okay. Again, I will repeat what is in the fat. The fat is also called as energy giving food because it also provides us energy, and it gives us more energy as compared to carbohydrate. It gives us fats we can get from the plant and animal sources. The sources like ghee, oil, butter, milk, meat, etc. And excessive fat causes obesity. What is meant by obesity? The fat stored in the body causes obesity. Okay. So this is all about today. In the next lecture, we will discuss about the next nutrient. So it is the time to tell you goodbye. So here I end my point. And for today, thank you.